Tide, Gain, Arm & Hammer, 7th Generation, and all laundry detergents were banned in New York State as of January 1st, 2023. But all of these products are still on the shelves. So what actually happened and why can you buy these illegal products? It's a really interesting story that boils down to a few key elements. The first being a New York State environmental law that went into effect in 2023. A small little laundry detergent company called Ingredients Matters posting a press release with pretty confusing information that, in turn, caused a lot of cleaning influencers to post their clickbait garbage reposting this information without doing any additional research. To properly cover the story, I wanted to do my due diligence, so I interviewed all of the big players involved in this. That includes the New York State DEC, Ingredients Matters, P&G, Procter & Gamble, and ACI, which is the American Cleaning Institute. So to all of those people, thank you for shedding some light on this and giving me clarity. So let's dive right into this. And for those who don't know me, my name is Zach. I'm a fourth generation dry cleaner and laundry enthusiast. And I want to provide an in-depth walkthrough of this New York State 1-4-dioxane law because I received so many questions and comments and DMs about what all of this meant and how their bodies and laundry would be affected. And for those unfamiliar with this funny sounding chemical, 1,4-dioxane, and its ban in New York State, you should know that it is a harmful manufacturing byproduct that exists in our cleaning products. And what's wonderful is that New York State is cracking down on it because 1,4-dioxane is not exactly good for us humans or the environment. To start this story, we're gonna time travel back to 2019 when these laws were passed by New York State. The goal of these laws, Articles 35 and 37, were to limit certain chemicals that are harmful to us humans and, more importantly, the environment. Some chemicals they want to limit in these laws include mercury, phosphorus, and our focus of this piece, 1,4-dioxane. And for context, the EPA has deemed 1,4-dioxane a probable carcinogen, which is not great, so something we should probably, if not definitely, avoid. So these New York State laws cover a few categories: cosmetics, personal care, think shampoo and body wash, and home cleaning products. That's where us and laundry detergent get involved. Basically, New York State said that any product that's going down the drain needs to be regulated much more closely. What's challenging for us as consumers is that New York State didn't provide a list of what was okay and compliant and what's not. So, going back to 2019, once these articles were turned into laws, manufacturers were given about 2.5 years or until December 31st of 2022 to become compliant with these new regulations. This means that this wide array of cleaning products all needed to be compliant by January 1st of 2023. And as for these products to actually be compliant, cosmetics required 1,4-dioxane to be below the 10 parts per million threshold. And for personal and cleaning products, it needs to be below 2 parts per million. And what would happen if manufacturers did not comply? Well, this was one of the questions I was really passionate about and asked the New York State DEC about it. And here is their answer. Hello, Zach. The department may test products subject to this law to assess compliance. Any product that is not covered by a waiver and that does not meet the allowable limits would not comply with the law. In terms of any addressing action, the department would have to evaluate the circumstances of each case, including who is responsible for the sale and distribution of the non-complying product and the best way to approach and achieve compliance with the law. Vague, to say the least. So now that we kinda understand the rules that New York State implemented, let's go back to the timeline. 2019, manufacturers were told, you gotta get in line, you got about 2.5, 3 years to figure it out. Think of it this way. Do you really think that P&G, which banks most of its revenue on Tide, is gonna mess around with this? They got 2.5 years to figure this out, otherwise their number one selling product of a multi-billion dollar company is gonna go down the toilet in a second. Doesn't make any sense to me. But every single detergent company that came under fire for this did such a bad job of communicating to their customers whether their products were okay or not. If it were me, I would be releasing my waivers and compliancy results and product information to say, this product is safe. You have nothing to worry about. We complied with the law. So if these companies were given a ton of warning and became compliant before the deadline, how did they get so much backlash from the online cleaning community? Well, That's where our now redacted press release from Ingredients Matters comes into play. Enter Ingredients Matters, a cute little laundry detergent company that makes a powdered laundry detergent that I actually like quite a bit. They released a now deleted press release that stated all Tide, Gain, Arm & Hammer, and 7th Generation were not compliant based on their independent testing. Just about every cleaning creator ate up this press release and then started posting about it in front of shelves saying, look at all this product, it's banned, don't buy it. So here's where things get confusing. Ingredients Matters purchased detergent that they wanted to test in 2022, before this New York State law went into effect. They had it tested, they did their writing, and then they posted it in March of 2023. To me, that's incredibly misleading because they didn't test detergent that was compliant. And how do I know the timeline of Ingredients Matters press release so well? Well, I asked them because I thought it was very confusing over a video call, and the meeting got tense very quickly, to say the least. And going back to the actual press release, which has now been removed or redacted from the internet, I asked them, well, why did you take it down? And they said, and I'm paraphrasing here because this meeting was like a year ago at this point, the lab that did the testing didn't want their name out there. Just take accountability. I don't understand. However, I don't think Ingredients Matters is totally to blame on this one. You have these enormous laundry detergent companies that spend tons of money on advertising, and they failed to get ahead of this. All of these laundry detergent manufacturers knew about this 2.5 year compliance warning, and they could have used that to their advantage, right? They could have said, hey, look at us, we're ahead of the curb, nothing to worry about here. Instead, big detergent brands were caught completely off guard, with their pants down, forced into reactive statements and enormous amounts of damage control. And I know this because I spoke to some pretty high up leadership at P&G and explained how they kind of fumbled the ball on this one and how it was an amazing missed opportunity to take a really unpleasant situation and turn into a really positive messaging one for their consumers. So, important piece of context, P&G let me know on record that they were compliant as of June 2022. So all the products they started shipping out in June, 6 months before the deadline, are compliant. To me, this is a really interesting story of misinformation and research. And to all the creators out there who posted maybe not the best content about it, I'll tell you this. Doing your own due diligence and your own research to make sure what you are communicating out into the world is correct is so unbelievably important. And if you were to post something that is not factual or not rooted in truth, you should be accountable and make corrections, because that also has an enormous amount of value to your audiences. Creators, here's some advice. Test your cleaning hacks, research laws, and provide sources. The amount of confusion and distrust and fear that you caused was unnecessary and disheartening, to say the least. So now what? Well, the good news is that New York State is cracking down even further and wants to reduce that 2 parts per million threshold down to 1 part per million. And then in 2025, they're gonna reevaluate the whole thing. So hopefully all those go down to 0. In a perfect world, I would have sent these detergents out to my own lab and presented the results to you. Unfortunately, our tiny little studio doesn't exactly have the budget for that. Luckily, Consumer Reports came to the rescue and did exactly that. So I'm gonna read a quote from their report telling you exactly what they found. To help you in that effort, Consumer Reports recently looked for potentially dangerous chemicals in 5 laundry detergents representing a cross-section of the marketplace: All, Dreft, 7th Generation, Tide, and Gain. The good news, none of the 5 products we tested had concerning levels of any of the chemicals we looked for. Those included 1,4-dioxane, a suspected carcinogen. This report was from May of 2023, this year. So all of those things that they tested were actually from after the compliance date. And if you're still here, here are my very honest thoughts on this whole thing. Number one, detergent companies, get all of this stuff out of your product. It's obviously bad for us humans and the environment, and that's not good. We have the technology to do other stuff, so let's do it. And to New York State, wouldn't it be amazing if there was some kind of label that went on our packaging to say, yeah, this is compliant, this is okay, this is within the thresholds? Or is there some kind of list or website or resource that we can use to protect ourselves and our families from potentially carcinogenic chemicals? Thank you so much for coming to my laundry detergent TED Talk. I hope you learned something today, and please let me know what questions you have. And I want to say a big thank you to all of the players who helped me get my questions answered. So P&G, New York State, Ingredients Matters, and the ACI. The amount of light you shed on this made things much more clear for me, so I can present all this information to you from what I think is a very neutral and honest perspective. Because at the end of the day, these are your products and your clothes and your bodies that they affect. So I hope this allows you to make an informed decision to keep you and your family safe.